Welcome to University of Chimera Stadium in steamy Tombstone, Arizona, where the only thing hotter than the heat is the ceaseless sinning. The players are ready to rock the red zone and red light district tonight. Let's go down to the field for kickoff. Both teams hit the field ready to hit each other in this MFL matchup. The Motor City Maniacs battle the Cardinal Sins. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. If you're just waking up wondering who put that vice on your head and filled your mouth with vacuum cleaner, dirt, and cat litter, you're not alone. After all, it's Sunday, MFL Game Day. Hey, you look tired, Junior. And Bricks, look like they just used your head in field goal practice.
Spent all night in the ER. We ate Chinese food last night.
Food poisoning?
I wish! I got the chopsticks lodged in my ears again. You know, they should have a warning on them things.
And it's first and 10. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. The 10. And a hard run there picks up the first down. First down and 5. He is fighting for every yard.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
Hey, man, nobody can touch me when I ball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, pal?
And it's first and 10. If you don't hear it coming, it'll knock you right on your ass.
Oh, man, he really...
And the quarterback finds his man for the first down.
Oh, man, he just killed that guy when the play was over.
Well, if the ref didn't see it, at least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. And it's first and 10. Second down and more than the QB would like. Oh, great pass on that play. They caught the defense napping. And that'll bring up third and 1. And that's the kind of play you pay the secondary for.
You pay him for the pick 6. For this, you just give him a pat on the head and tell him they don't suck.
And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
They just let that one drop and played safe, and the defense says, we'll take it. And it's first and 10. Oh, and the late hit arrives right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time. Second down and 6.
You can't keep a good mutant down.
And like Brix's balls, boom to the moon. Another loser bites the dust. Winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
And it's first and 10. Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got dead mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to buy.
Giants has only two running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to hit those last two runners for this outman.
And it's first and goal. Defense says enough of this BS and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. It's first and 10. Does the QB know which team he's on? Boom!
Bingo! Bingo! I just hit that mutant bingo! And all I was missing was his number for the last three plays! Talk about luck!
And it's first and 10. Stepped up and blew up. He's got a lot of guts, doesn't he? And you can see the grounds crew cleaning him up now. Hot potato gets him every time. And it's first and 10. And I've had it. I'm running out of excuses for this QB. Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. It's first and 10. Oh, look at this guy break tackles. He takes a lick and it keeps on ticking. Second down in a very lot. And that pass is good for about 5 yards. Third down and 8. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. Oh, man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. No good. Now that punter's gonna find a cutoff bison, and he just lets that one go. He says no thank you, and the defense downs it. And it's first and 10. And that pass finds its target, a pickup of 6 yards on the play. And that'll be second down and 4. And he's running like a moose right now. Third down and 6. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? And it's first and 10. Second down and 5. Ah! Caught, boom, dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy. except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, I mean, he was a great ball player. You know, that's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
First down and seven. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown!
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see it. I'm too fast.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned out the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
And it's first and ten. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
Second down and two. That's the end of the first quarter, and it's still anyone's game.
Oh, could it be mine?
Second down and two. Crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with no mustard?
And it's first and ten. At this rate, the QB's gonna have more interceptions than completion. No doubt about it, that guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. Totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they have raincoats in the front row because that was splattering everywhere.
And it's first and ten. Gets another pick. Man, rough day. He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? And it's first and ten. Second down and long. And with
it was just another day at the office for this guy. You know, he killed his boss at his old job. That's why they drafted him.
And it's first and ten. For 6 yards. Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the NFL. The offense lost another quarterback on the previous play and have only two left before they have to forfeit.
Yeah, but on the bright side, Grim, they save a ton of money by not having to pay those guys anymore. Other than the funeral expenses, that is.
And that'll be second down and four. QB passes it for maybe a yard. They've got to open up the offense here, Bricks. Third down and three. Kill.
Did you know late hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schwan Galaxy phone.
He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. And he's got a chance for a good return here. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. It's first and 10. And then the work beat Dirty Brick. Look at him. There's another pick.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
And it's first and 10. A big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. It's first and 10. Oh, the unstoppable force meets the explodable object. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. Oh, come on, that was a cheap shot. That's why I love this guy. And so do the fans. Offense lost another running back and only two remain on their roster. When a team loses all their running backs, they lose their ability to run the ball.
Yeah, like if I rip out your tongue, you won't be able to speak. Tell us something we don't know, genius.
First down and inches. The defense had enough with this rep and jumps off sides to kill him. First and 10. At this rate, the QB's... Oh, that's a vicious hit. And the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. And it's first and 10.
Toe-to-toe with me? Well, you mistaken, man. You get up my grill, I'm gonna ruin your world. I'm gonna wreck it.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
It's first and ten. Second down and a lot. And he punched his way out of that, and he finds open space. He's running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
Oh, hold everything. Looks like there's a penalty on the play. Excuses for this QB. You just, ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and ten. Is a rock, and the quarterback drills one in for the first down.
Oh, man, he just killed that guy when the play was over.
Well, if the ref didn't see it, at least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. And they stop the clock with their first time out to try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game. Hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. And the offense quickly calls their second timeout. That's how you do it.
Do what?
Second down and two.
Murphy Brown!
What?
I mean...
Oh, holy smokes! He just killed that player with a cheap shot. That's why we love the NFL. And that's it. That's the last time out. It's score or die from here out. And it's first and ten. Oh, man. He just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're going to hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor. Finish him.
When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock.
Ah, another interception. It's a real blow to the team.
Man, what a hit. That guy is not getting up. First and ten. He was starting to go somewhere, but he gets stumped after three.
They usually stop me after three, too. You know, the all-you-can-eat buffets? They're not as literal as you'd think.
Second down and seven. And the defense gives up 5 yards there. Second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. We're back for the second half as the teams line up for the kickoff. The coach told his players they'll be strung up on the goalposts if they don't make this a game in the second half.
That's how you motivate these pricks.
Looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and ten. And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. And it's first and ten.
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Graham.
Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. Broke free and has open field in front of him. The offense is down to their last running back. No rest for the weary. The last runner has to suck it up and hopefully not die. And it's first and ten. Kaboom! And the quarterback unleashes a sonic blast against the defense.
Holy mother of mutant mayhem, he scored!
Yo, man, nobody can touch you with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
And here comes the extra point attempt. Goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And it's first and ten. Just lays a vicious hit on the receiver and jars the ball loose. Second down and 10. Wow, the quarterback just threw a sonic blast to his receiver, knocking down the entire defense. And he held on to that one for a first down. First and ten. And that's another pick. Man, oh man, the defense is gonna hit. Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
No, still working on my salami here, Briggs. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. First and ten.
Turn on your juice, you son of a bitch!
The offense is running low on quarterbacks. They have only two left. They might consider running the ball more. And it's first and ten. He scores! He earned those points on the heels of an epic run.
Don't call things epic, Grim. Kids aren't going to think you're cool no matter what you do.
Junior, I don't want kids to think I'm cool. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
Straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. They're going to be able to return this one. Boom to the moon! Another loser bites the dust. In the NFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
And it's first and ten. And he runs it in for the touchdown. It should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It's good. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Briggs. It certainly does. High five. And it's first and ten. He could go all the way. The 30. The 20. He's at the 10. He rushed touchdown. And he rumbles that one into the end zone. Nicely done.
I can't run like that unless it's coupon night at Taco Hell. He has better footwork though than me on account of not clenching his cheeks though.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and ten. And he zings it in there for a 9-yard completion. They're moving the ball now with authority. And that'll bring up second and one. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's first and ten. And that's another turnover for the defense. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my off season.
And it's first.
his face. I want to see if the little bastard's crying.
Hey, man, I scared him with shiver. I am a hell of a son.
Second down in a mile. Oh, and that's how you play defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
I do. The guy should have fucking caught it.
And with another pick, the QB says, I don't know.
Oh, with a brutal hit.
Yeah, man, I was hit on the kettle now. You know what I mean?
And it's first and 10. And an 8-yard gain on that one.
Like when Brix's mom decided to move back in with us.
Second down and 2. First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Brix. And it's first and 10. First down. And they're running game. Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
The Cardinal sins get crushed and lose by forfeit. Someone get more body bags. It's probably a good thing the game ended up in forfeit. They weren't going to make it out of the stadium alive with this performance anyway. The fans were going to kill them if the opposition didn't.
Gotta love that fan passion.
Let's hear what the game's MVP has to say about this carnage.
I'd rather listen to Sarah Palin read the entire works of Shakespeare while tripping my brains out.
Actually, that sounds kind of fun.
Once again, the folks at EvilSN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Microhard Corporation. They get it right every up.